The nation's largest union for educators moves to adopt new language declaring its support for abortion. Delegates at last week's National Education Association convention in Houston moved to adopt a new business item stating, quote, "The NEA vigorously opposes all attacks on the right to choose and stands on the fundamental right to abortion under Roe v. Wade." Joining me now by Skype from Midland, Texas is Rebecca Friedrichs, founder of Four Kids in Country, a coalition of parents, teachers, and faith leaders. Rebecca has been a public school teacher in California for 28 years. Rebecca, welcome to the broadcast. Thanks so much for taking time out of your vacation to talk with us. As a pro-life woman and an educator, what concerns you the most about this new resolution?
Well, everything about it concerns me. You know, the NEA for decades has been pushing a very far-left agenda, including full-term abortion. And teachers like myself have been deeply concerned about this. They use our money, they use our profession, our trusted profession, to push an agenda. And that's not what a union is supposed to be about. So I'm deeply concerned.
Well, why do you think this language was proposed and then voted on?
Well, the teachers union has actually been pushing for this sort of language for decades. I have teacher friends who've worked within the NEA Representative Assembly, which is their group of about 8,000 teachers who are supposed to represent all of us. And those of us who are conservative, Christians, pro-life, get into these NEA meetings and we're bullied. And we try to push back on their agenda. And anyone who speaks out against it is harshly silenced. So, you know, the majority of teachers, even those who might even be pro-choice, the majority of teachers do not agree with abortion all the way up to birth. And so this is a very radical agenda pushed off the backs of teachers who don't agree with it.
I want to follow up on an earlier point that you made, because for conservative educators like yourself, I want to ask you if you feel like there's any room within the NEA for your viewpoints. I mean, is there any way for you to actually sneak in, get in, try to get your values in place?
You know, I'm so glad you asked that question, because I thought there was, and that's why I served as a union leader for 3 years. I was on the executive board of my local association. And what I discovered when I went to a state level conference was that anyone who speaks out against a hard left radical agenda of the teachers unions, as I said before, we're bullied and we're silenced. So there is absolutely no room within the NEA or the state level teachers associations for the hearts and the beliefs of loving teachers across this country, who, by the way, are paying these unions billions of dollars annually. So in my opinion, teachers need to stand together at their local level, and we need to say goodbye to these state and national unions who are misrepresenting us.
Do you think there's some sort of conflict of interest in terms of when it comes to money or politics?
Absolutely. I don't think a union should be involved in politics at all. They're supposedly there to make sure that we have fair working environments. But unfortunately, these unions are getting involved in so much political just advocacy in all sorts of ways that they're actually destroying the teaching profession, making our classrooms dangerous, bringing harm to the very children that we're hired to serve. As in this case, they're in danger in the womb, my future students.
What do you think then, noting how bad this is, what do you think are options for educators who don't want this sort of union representation?
Well, thank God, last June 2018, we won a case at the United States Supreme Court. It was called Janus versus AFSCME. That case has given all teachers, in fact, all government employees, the freedom to stop paying unions today. They can opt out right now and stop paying. Now, they have to know they will get bullied. The teachers' unions will isolate them, call them free riders and all of these things. But if we stand on our moral principle and say, I'm not gonna let my money go to the slaughter of my future students or to the damage of my own profession or my country, we can all stand together. And another thing I've learned talking to thousands of teachers across the country, I represented them in another lawsuit that went to the Supreme Court in 2016. And all these teachers have told me, I really like standing together in a local association, but I resent the state and national unions who politicize us. Teachers, we can stand together and decertify them and just have a local association. So there's a lot of good options out there.
This is such an important issue and one that's not often brought to light. So we're glad that you came on here and were able to talk with us about it. Rebecca Friedrichs, founder, For Kids and Country. Thanks so much.
Thank you.